Do you have any Def Leppard from when the drummer had two arms?
Yeah, left me to the best.
Thanks.
Footloose told the story of Beaumont, a small Midwest town in the USA where dancing was banned by the church and council, aka the Squares.
Obscene rock and roll music.
Kevin Bacon starred as a young rebel determined to overturn the ban by proving the passages in the Bible not only condone but encourage the joy of dance.
In Ecclesiastes assures us that there is a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to laugh, and a time to weep. A time to mourn, and there is a time to dance.
What a brilliant film. The powerful storyline and anti-authoritarian soundtrack make you want to moonwalk and backspin, free from society's restraints. Although the main dance number does feature Kevin Bacon in a shadowy silhouette, suggesting a stunt double was used for some of the more difficult stuff. Nevertheless, his fiery performance, whilst punching out the biblical passages, is so well realised it makes you want to press pause on the video and go out and battle your own fight against the establishment.
And what did David do? Leaping and dancing before the Lord. Leaping and dancing.
And if you think this whole dance band thing is some crazy notion plucked out of a screenwriter's head, think again. Because here in Pound, Virginia, in the USA, the town council, reflecting the local community's Christian values, passed a new law in the year 2000, making dancing in public without a permit illegal. And here in St Kilda, in Melbourne, Australia, well, that's where I went to school.
I know about your school days, your salad years. You had your school socials, you had your end of year 12 formals, you had your debutante balls, you had your end of term discos. But let me tell you, there was no dancing for little Johnny Baby. No, whilst you're off lambardering, time warping, nut bush sitting, I was stuck here at Yeshiva College, where every dance with girls was the forbidden dance.
That's because my parents insisted on sending me to one of the world's most religious, single-sex Hasidic Jewish schools. Unfortunately for me, that single-sex was boys.
There was a sister school next door, but we were separated by a fence. They were on one side, we were on the other. And never the twain shall dance.
I went and spoke to my old school teacher, Rabbi Groner, about the issue.
And how come we never had school dances?
How do you mean?
Like, you know, at the end of the year having a mixed dance like, you know, other schools.
Very simply, rock and roll type of music is it uncages the animal within you. Because this is exactly what music and religion tries to counteract. That the music should be expressing the godly aspect of the human being, the humane aspect, not the animal.
So mixed, we have dancing, animal. Mixed dancing can like lead to like spiritual corruption.
Mixed dancing could, yes, it could lead to, we know what it could lead to. When it's men and women dancing together, which could have sexual orientations and sexual connotations and so on.
So if I want to live as a more religious Jew, like I should just rule it out? Like is it worse than like eating pork or the same? Or
as I said before, and I'm repeating it again, I said that there's a limited amount that can be said and explained to give justice to the concept.
So, like if I see a woman on TV dancing, should I watch it or should I turn the channel?
I don't think that's not in the context of this interview.
Okay. It's about dancing.
It was me.
Okay.
And clearly the rabbi was down on dance, so I decided to use the arguments Kevin Bacon used to win over his religious leader in Footloose.
Does not Tehillim 149 tell us, praise ye the Lord, let them praise his name in the dance? And King David, Dovid HaMelech in Samuel in Shmuel, What did he do? He danced before the Lord with all his might.
Absolutely.
Leaping and dancing with all his might. Leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes tells us there's a time for every purpose under the heaven. A time to laugh, a time to weep, a time to mourn. And yes, there is a time to dance.
Absolutely. You're very erudite in your quotes. And
despite Rabbi Groner being impressed by my quotes from the Book of Footloose, the school's law against dancing was clearly going to remain unturned.
There was a time for this law, but not anymore. You see, now is our time to dance. It's our way of celebrating life. It's the way it was in the beginning. It's the way it's always been. It's the way it should be now. Screw no dancing. I was born to dance. I intend to flout the rules of the religious establishment a la Kevin Bacon and cut footloose. I have some making up to do.
Did you know it was only a few days later that John realised the irony of taking bacon onto school grounds?
He knows the inner secrets of the music industry, but for fear of retribution, he must hide his identity. He is the music mole.
Mr. Mole, apparently there were record companies crying foul at the 2001 ARIA Music Awards.
Well, that's right, John. There was even talk of an industry boycott.
What possibly would cause such a scandal?
Well, the board of the ARIAs is made up of music industry heavyweights, so it's not unusual that in any given year, the head of the ARIAs is also top banana at a record label. And so the conflict of interest charges begin.
What kind of charges?
Well, in 2001, the ARIAs was chaired by Dennis Handlin. Now, he's also head of Sony Australia. Do you remember who hosted the ARIAs in 2001?
Can't say I do, Mr. Mole.
Musician David Campbell. You know the son of Jimmy Barnes?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, guess what record label he was signed to?
I think I know what you're going to say, Mr. Mole.
That's right, John. Sony. So the other labels were saying, what a coincidence. A Sony act hosting the ARIAs when the head of Sony is also chairman. And this is why there were rumours of a boycott from rivals Festival Mushroom.
So did they follow through on this boycott?
No, of course not. They caved in entirely, John.
Oh, well, it could have been worse.